Camping in Ohio after the East Palestine train derailment. Is the air quality safe? Who the fuck knows? But you would have to be a fool to think that just the chemicals settled in East Palestine, you know? They have to be all over Ohio, Pennsylvania, West Virginia. I mean, they spread, not just through the water, but, you know, if it went up in the clouds and, you know, made acid rain like they're saying, then everyone has to be worried. And it's not like you got to be worried soon. It's going to give you cancer, you know, that's what they say. And it seems about right if you look back at all the history and what's already happened already, you know. But who knows? Nobody knows. Only the people that know, you know? Ten, 20 years down the line, you know, you're going to be fucked. You know what else sucks? Is it's like, you can't even say what you think anymore without getting in trouble, you know? So, in a huge sense, nobody is free at all. But let me just shut up there. going to see if it's possible to brew up a hot chocolate over the alcohol stove. Because I only brought enough water to either make a soup or have a hot chocolate. And I think I'm just going to eat these Vienna sausages and have me a hot chocolate. Cool. Let's see how long this will take. There we go. The wind kind of dies down a little bit. It won't be such a bad idea. And yes, you did see me pull this little fire rack out my camper. I figure, hell, instead of buying one, might as well just make one, you know? Gotta be honest though, you just gotta hope that it all ain't what it really seems, you know, if that makes sense. It does to me. That would suck. It would suck to constantly be afraid, you know what I'm saying? It would suck to think cancer's in the air. That's a really big deal. It doesn't seem like a big deal to people now. People are like, ah, whatever. This dude's a fucking loony. Well, it's not even that. It's just, it was a big city, you know, or a nice sized town. And you would have to be a fool to think that that big smoke cloud only hovered above East Palestine, you know? It is gonna mess up a lot if what they're saying is true, you know? If it's that dangerous of chemicals. Just think, when it rained, it landed on every tree, all the dirt, all your houses, all the cars, you know? It didn't just rain in East Palestine. It rained in all of Ohio. You know what I mean? Like, you gotta really not be a fool to put it all together. But nobody can put it all together besides the people that know, so. But it would suck, you know, to die of cancer in 10 or 20 years. You'd be like, man, I knew that I should have just got the hell out of there. But then again, if you get the hell out of here, they're going to do it everywhere. So, really, there's nothing you could do about it. But just play ball, you know? But this is a very, it is a very serious situation. You know, it's nothing to be taken lightly. This is all of our kids' lives and stuff like that, like, in jeopardy for the years to come, you know?
So I fixed that porch light.
Definitely starting to get cold now. Every time, if you don't do anything and you're just sitting around, start to get cold, man. Starts with my fingers, then my ears. Like, damn. Thank you. hot chocolate's way better than a soup, that's for sure. Barbecue Vienna sausages. Get a nice hot brew going this time, hot chocolate wise. Oh yeah, that one's gonna be nice and hot. I've been meaning to get this Stanley Cook cup for man, quite some years, but I always seem to get everything I want first instead of what I need, you know what I mean? I've been needing it for so long. Oh. And it just seems like I never get what I need. I always get what I want, you know? I should have had all my cookware and everything like that first, you know? But instead, I was buying tarps and, you know, solar lights and dumb shit. Well, not dumb, but stuff that could have waited. Yes, that one is very hot. Very hot. Oh. Matter of fact, I might have cooked some of the hot chocolate out of it. I'm thinning it out. So yeah, I never tried, you know, hanging anything over a alcohol stove, but if you get it close enough and you do it for 10-15 minutes, it'll work. Finally went out. It's been going for about 45 minutes. Yep. It's the truth. You might call me a liar, but I ain't. Yep. About 45 minutes is how long it's been going. But I filled it all the way up. Damn near. Almost. Yes, my hands are starting to really get cold. people are probably like, well, if you're so cold, why don't you get inside your camper, inside your sleeping bag? And the truth is there wouldn't be much fun in that. You know, if you're a real camper, you should enjoy as much nature time as you can, no matter how hot, how cold it is while you're out. You should be expecting that and be prepared for that. So what I like to do is I like to spend most of the time outside. And if you get too cold, you gotta, you know, do some work. And at the end, I crawl in my camper, get cozy, you know? And that's how that works, you know? This is just for sleeping. You can sit up in it, lean up against the back wall or whatever and read a book or do whatever that way. But, you know, when you're out camping, you're supposed to spend as much time outside as you can, you know? And, you know, it's like you take a hot tent with you and a wood stove, you're going to want to be inside that hot tent the whole time, being nice and toasty, you know? And that's totally fine. But, you know, I think nature is more important. Has this great effect to it, you know? And you could just sit and just look at everything, you know? It's a wonderful thing. It's cheesy, but true. Okay, here's that part I was talking about, getting nice and toasty. You know what's crazy? Is it's like 10 degrees warmer in here than it is outside. Just because my sleeping bag insulation and my pads and stuff. I just throw my jacket right here on the side of me and my snowsuit if I got one, and makes everything much better, warmer, especially if it's cold out.
Well, all right, everyone. I hope you enjoyed camping in Ohio with me after the train crash. I enjoyed it myself, and as always, till next time.